Wonderful March, written not by an American, written by a Czech composer. Been a day of surprises, and look, the audience comes eagerly in. How lovely to see you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. Do we have more chairs? This is wonderful. Just so wonderful. Of course, we were guessing nobody's going to come because of rain, change of venue, and here you are. Thank you.
Yeah, here, here.
So, let's see. I'll tread water for a little bit because we're about to do a piece, a very significant piece, very substantial piece in three longish movements that has nothing to do with the 4th of July. Nothing, right? So I have spent the past period, and I invited from the rehearsal last night, the orchestra to contribute, how on earth can we justify doing this piece on the 4th of July, right? Now, I don't remember the Hill of Beans because it is an extraordinary piece that I declare is perfect for the 4th of July, but I just don't know why. I did find a reason overnight when I was working on the score. I found hidden in the third movement a quote from the climax of God Bless America. God Bless America. So there we go. That's a justification for why. See if you can find it, right? It's in there. Goes by, but it's in there, right? Now, does anybody else have any great ideas that you'd like to tell me about why this is a perfect piece for the 4th of July? Michelle, I know you can sing.
During the war, lots of people died, so that's the funereal part. And then the apotheosis is that the country was born.
So what Pedro's referring to is an explicit program by the composer of this thing, French composer called Berlioz, right? Traditionally, the English hate the French. Traditionally, also the Americans hate the French, right? And there are things that, you know, go on about that. It sort of does a dance, but sort of sits there as an unpleasant sort of feeling set to deal with. So this is written by Berlioz, and it's called the Symphonie Funèbre et Triomphale. The funereal and triumphant symphony. Now you have to wait for the triumph. The triumph is enormous, but it's a bit of a burn before we get there. And it's a two-level burn. The first part of the long, slow burn is mighty impressive. You will see. And then there is an official funeral oration, and you will see the orator move from her place in the trombone section and give a eulogy, an elevated eulogy to an enormous grieving crowd, right? State funeral type of thing. And then she'll return to her trombone post. So that's the plan of this thing. Okay, I can invite you to play another. No, there's one more thing I want to do. So there are so many joys doing what I do. A particular joy for today is our triumph, sort of small-term triumph over adversity, weather, uncertainty, what to do, right? And this is a wonderful, wonderful result. Slightly longer term than that is we the Windham Philharmonic, have a commitment to collaboration, and I will invite all members of the American Legion Band to stand and receive applause. Wonderful for us. I hope it's wonderful for them. It's wonderful, wonderful for us. They are not our only guests. If you have traveled from somewhere that isn't in Winton County, would you stand up and receive applause also? I know there are minimum three of you. And final group to stand up, those who were dragooned at the last minute into play or decided at the last minute that they wanted to play. Stand up, those who were. That's the press gang crowd. Okay, I'll invite you to take a nice calm B flat, please, to agree upon.
Thank you.
3 minutes rest after that, if you don't mind. So take a little stretch break and we'll come back fairly soon. Oh yeah, there's a bake sale. There's a bake sale outside. Give us lots of money for baked goods. Please do. Goodbye and have a wonderful summer. We hope to be at the next level of shall we say, stability and availability for more regular concerts, more earlier announced concerts in the coming years. Now, I'll tell you two uncomfortable truths, which you may or may not be interested in, but I'll tell you anyhow. The first one is, for different reasons, mostly to do with COVID, we suffered significant membership loss. We're very proud of this. Look at this. This is unusual, right?
Yeah.
So somehow...
Yeah.
Somehow, we noticed that we're beginning to be attractive to bodies of players who perhaps, I don't know why they weren't interested before, but look, we have some players. So there's a growth in membership. I don't think it'll be consistent. I think it'll be very jagged shape, but it is nevertheless a growth. That's the bit that affects me and us more than it affects you. The bit that affects you, if you're interested in being affected by it, is the call for money, right? So that is the other obstacle that we have had in pulling ourselves together in the ways we would like to post-pandemic. So we, of course, would be delighted if you were willing to give past what you consider to be a standard donation, what you consider to be as a reasonable ticket price. You don't have to do anything of what I'm saying. It's just an invitation to consider it, and then a second invitation to act on it if you have considered it favorable. So please, 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 if you have good intentions towards us, it'd be so useful to us for our growing and our growth if it were realized with gifts of money. Thank you. There are some impressively large looking donation jars just outside the door. And I understand the website is capable of receiving donations now. Is that correct? No, the website is not yet equipped for donations. So, well, where does that leave us? So,
just the jar.
You probably have friends who are here. You could hand them enormous checks. You could, Venmo. I don't know what. There's all sorts of possibilities. But you get the point. That's what we're after. That's a very important call for us to make of you. Now, here's something how we can sort of bring some of these strands together here and now. At least one person in this room, am I seeing more than one person in this room, has actually conducted the Windham Orchestra as was. And that's Peter over there, right? Peter has conducted. I don't want this to take long, but if you were to hand over $800 right now, I would let you conduct the Liberty Bell March from Philip Sousa, which is what we're going to play next, with or without you, right? So I'll count down from five. If you jump out of your seat, you can either hand over $800 or a figure of your choosing, right? Five, four, three, going. God, was that a joke? It was a joke, wasn't it? Okay, good. So I'll give $800 myself and conduct the
good.
This is the Liberty Bell of John Philip Sousa.
All right.
I'll make you a similar offer, beginning at like Sibylline Books. The next offer will be the final march of the evening for $1,200, right? just think of that.
Thank you.
So I have not spent my whole life conducting Sousa marches. I spent a lot of it conducting Sousa marches. I wasn't born in America, you see. And so it's, I was taught about famous composers in a book that included Bach, Beethoven, Brahms, Tchaikovsky, Vivaldi, maybe Rachmaninoff, and John Philip Sousa. This is a little strange, given it's an English textbook. And to me, he's an exotic composer. He's a very foreign, fascinating, alien from anything that I was brought up with. Please believe me in this. I experienced a real delight in conducting these things. No matter how many times, I just love this flavor that isn't mine, of energy, exuberance, pageantry, 4th of July, obviously. On the other hand, I was brought up with Handel, and this is you're observing me wrestling with something called an iPad. So in a moment we're going to tune to an A rather than the B flat that a lot of the brass instruments and band protocols prefer. So we'll tune to the A. This is just an extraordinary work. You'll find similarities and differences with the Berlioz. This is a mass occasion work, crowds as far as the eye can see, pageantry, a sense of celebration that is beyond the personal, right? Just an extraordinary thing. This is the music for the Royal Fireworks. I'm not a royalist, but you might find some interesting parallels with any music that was played for the coronation that was recently in England's history, I am told.
Thank you.
It's over. Look, it turned out sunny. You could have gone outside after all.